Stupid, I'm not gonna let you get the chance.
You may think you know everything about PUBG Mobile, but I'm sorry, you just don't. There are so many glitches and secret locations in this game, in all of the different maps, that we can only dream of. Ways to get underneath of Erangel, ways to get inside of secret doors and behind walls that you were never intended to go behind. In today's video, I'm going to show you guys 5 plus 1 bonus, so technically 6 of those secret locations, and I hope you guys are going to enjoy. If you guys do enjoy this and you learn something new, all I ask is to take just a second and leave a like down below. It helps out the channel a ton, and it lets me know you want to see more videos like this coming out very soon. Thank you so much, guys. Subscribe for more, and let's get into this. Alright guys, so we are starting things off in Sanhok with a bang. This is probably the most well-known one that I'm showing in this video, and that's why I'm showing it first. Later on in this video, they're gonna get that much more crazy. You're gonna be heading right around into this area of Paradise Resort, where I put my marker conveniently, and this is literally a glitch that is going to get you underneath the building in Paradise Resort. I know it sounds crazy, but look at how simple this is. You literally run, go prone, and you can crawl right underneath the building. This is obviously a development error, and I have no idea how this got past their testing stages, but the fact of the matter is, you can go underneath the map, and this is definitely not something that was intended. Obviously, this is something that can get you banned if you end up trying to kill people when you're underneath the map. They're going to report you. So don't do this in a public server. Only do this in a private server with your friends. And that way, you don't run the risk of getting banned. You will get banned if you do this in a public server. And I don't want any of that to happen to you guys. Do not take that risk. Continuing on, though, with another secret location. This is something pretty cool. We're going to be heading right over toward the south end of the right bridge connecting the smaller island to the bigger island in Erangel, sort of near Novo, if you know where that location is. This is a way where you can actually wedge your dune buggy up underneath the bridge and then see through it when you change your seat. So I am very much finessing my little dune buggy underneath the bridge, and then when I click the change seat button, I can actually see right through the bridge, and I can see if somebody is coming before they see me. So this is perfect where, again, you're not in a public server. You only do this in a private server. You could be doing hide and seek, and no one would know that you're there. This is like the ultimate hiding spot. There was a guy that tried to just run me over there. I jumped out of the way in the nick of time, but conveniently, I actually was able to get a grenade from him, and I'll show you guys what it's sort of like when you use a grenade. So, again, in that private server, you can throw a grenade. Maybe test out this on your friends. You can prank them because you can't shoot through the building, but you can throw a grenade through the bridge. I said building. I meant to say bridge. Anyways, with that being said, now that the zone is closing in, let's move on to the third secret location. This is not a glitch, but it's something that is very, very complex, all right? Right over here in this area of Milta, more actually toward the south end of Milta, I would say, there is a set of containers that you can use a motorbike and fly up on top of, okay? I'm sure you've seen those compilations where people get those motorbikes and then they land in those crazy areas in the map. Well, this is one of them, and it's actually very useful. I did not find myself a motorbike, as you can see, so it did take me a few minutes to actually find one. It's always, you know, the times when you're recording and you need to find something that you don't, but hey, as you can see, I finally found one. You're probably gonna find one pretty close to Milta, but it would be a good idea if that final circle is getting close to Milta to have a motorbike on hand, because you're probably not gonna find one toward the end. You're gonna head over toward this antenna tower that I am driving to. This is going to give you the proper amount of speed and buildup before you get to the final ramp, and then you're just gonna floor it. And you'll notice, this is like one of my many, many attempts. I did not get it this time. I floor it, and I aim for this little incline in the ground. And if I hit it just right, I will land on top of the containers, which I did not do just then. Now, there are several areas that you would want to hit. Right about where my crosshair is right here is a pretty good area. I would recommend angling toward that spot in between those two green patches, or right here is actually pretty good. One area that you do not want to go toward is this, because as you can see, it's very steep and your motorbike is not going to be able to hit the ramp properly. Since I didn't get it, I'm going to show you guys some footage from a YouTuber named RMachaX. He actually got it. I'll link his channel down below in the description. And this is sort of what it looks like if you can actually do it successfully. You land up on top of these little containers here, and you can have a fantastic vantage point on anybody that is down below. Next up, though, this one is arguably one of the biggest ones that I'm going to show in this video, with a possible exception of the very last one that I will show. I made a private server because it's relatively difficult to do in a public match. Again, as I said, you don't want to do this in a public match, but if you wanted to do it just to test it out for fun and not kill anybody, I guess you can. You're going to have a friend with you, and we are going to get underneath this little area of school that I am running on right here. It's another glitch, so again, it's going to take a lot of practice, but as you can see, I have my other account right here. The main account that you want to glitch into the wall is going to hold the sprint button and then go into that corner. Your other account is just going to spam running and then the prone button over and over and over and over again. And then eventually it's going to bump your main account into the wall. And as you can see, you're in for a very special treat. You can see anybody else that's on the outside, but no one can see that you're in there. You're actually underneath this area of school, and I gotta say, it's probably one of the coolest things I've ever seen in this game. I didn't think there would ever be a glitch in school in PUBG Mobile, but there you go. It is there. Now, the good thing is, you can't actually shoot anybody from within this glitch, so it's not like it's gonna massively change gameplay, but hey, it's fun to test out, and I would totally recommend doing this every once in a while. Your friend will not be able to kill you. You will not be able to kill your friends, and you're sort of stuck in there once you actually get inside. There may be some ways to get out, but I do not know that for certain. And then for the fifth secret location of this video, we're going to head over to toward Goroka in Vikendi, and I'm going to show you how you can get, again, underneath the map. Yes, there are so many underneath the map glitches. I wasn't lying in the intro, okay? What we're going to do is we're going to land right over toward where the little boardwalk goes out into the water. I guess we could say it's like a dock or something like that. Right over toward this area right here. Now, here's the thing. This is another one that is extremely difficult, and a lot of people might not even be able to do it at all. But if you notice, there are areas of the boardwalk that are raised up from the ice. And if you punch and jump at the same time, your character might have a chance of actually glitching through the wall. Of course, you gotta be careful for bots trying to kill you while you're doing this, but eventually, you might end up doing it. As you'll see, the zone has already closed in on me, and when I tell you it took me a long time and I still didn't get it, I literally was trying this nonstop for like 10 minutes straight, and I could not get this for the life of me. But you essentially just press the punch button, and you jump at the same time, and you sort of glitch down through the floor if you do it correctly. I did not successfully do it in this video, but it's sort of simple, I guess. You just have to be lucky in having your game glitch up a bit and allowing you to get through the floor. Here's footage from somebody named VLNGaming who actually does it the right way. And as you can see, you are underneath the lake, the frozen lake, in Vikendi. And it's probably one of the coolest glitches in the entirety of the history of Vikendi. And hey, would you look at that? You stayed this far in the video. I have one final special secret location that I will have for the people that actually stayed this far in the video. This is the best secret location of this entire video, and probably one of the best secret locations slash glitches that I have ever seen in the history of this game. It is so cool. I don't know. Let's just show it, shall we? And here we are for our final bonus secret location of this video. Look where my marker is, over by the military base, in that exact spot. I will show you guys how you can get underneath the map. You're going to land by this little bunker. This bunker in particular is a little bit glitchy. You can see it's the one that's at the farthest northwest of the map. Now, after you get yourself some weapons just to potentially defend yourself if anybody comes up and tries to mess you up, you're going to find that spot in the ground. Now, this is a very, very glitchy spot. You can already tell by my character wandering all over the place and having some weird physics errors. But you can actually fall through the ground, and if you're lucky, you can actually land underneath the map. Now, as you can see, you're going to take multiple tries, and a lot of times you're going to end up just popping right up normally, and other times you might end up glitching into areas you did not want to go into. If you get stuck in the wall, generally, you can just climb your way back out. But if you do it right, watch as I do right here. I climb, I go underneath, and I go right along the edge of the tunnel. If my character gets glitched into the rocks, I might find myself in this spot right here. This is underneath the map in Erangel. And look at this. Very few people have ever seen something like this. I didn't know the tunnel went back this far. I mean, this is just the craziest thing. And the fact that this actually is something that you can do in PUBG Mobile in late 2020 is just absolutely awesome. I would highly recommend trying this out in a private match with your friends. I mean, looking at the tunnel from the other side is just the coolest thing ever. You really cannot deny. It's probably one of the most pleasing to the eyes that I've ever seen in my entire life. But yeah, that is our bonus secret location. And as I said, probably one of the best secret locations I have ever seen in PUBG Mobile. And with that, that wraps things up for today's video. This video took a lot of time to make, and all I ask is if you stayed this far, take just 1 second and leave a like, and then subscribe to my channel if you want to see more PUBG videos like this coming out very soon. This was a special video, and I hope you guys enjoyed it. I know I haven't posted enough PUBG recently, but I hope this made the wait worth it. I hope you guys did enjoy, and we're out of time, so hey, I hope it's not going to be too long till the next upload. Until then, I'll see you guys then. Have a great rest of your day, and I'll see you all later.